Hey guys, it's Nakia Nichelle with Chicago Tribune's ChicagoNow.com. Someone is trying to get me tipsy tonight. It's my girl.
Okay. That, don't listen to a word she just said. You she's going to take the ownership today.
Together for Marjorie.
What do you mean?
Congratulations, Mark, for everything that you were able to achieve and all the stuff that you're still doing and all the stuff that you are yet to do. Have a good show, and you guys enjoy yourselves tonight.
Your hearts, your ears, to the sounds of the messages.
Cause I am a messenger, and I've accepted my call to go out and tell all of the world of my Savior. I praise your name.
I'm bowling with my girl, Brave Williams. We have some drinks on deck. We are ready to get started, so stay tuned. We're gonna keep this fun, live, and entertaining.
Right, be chillin', like the feeling. You be bugging out on me, but I'm still chillin'. Might just be the baddest chicken bout to mine, but you can handle it, cause now I'm internet.
Great, bro, Timmy, now let's talk about the music for a while. I mean, cause you know, you kinda got pushed into acting.
Well, you know what, while I was doing Boston, even when I was doing, I had a downtime even when I was filming movies.
Okay.
All I could do was record and just write about what I'm seeing. I couldn't really perform, I couldn't really do much because I was tied to this. So I had time to cultivate my craft for years now. So we're at the point where I'm on the show and 50 heard my records. And he was like, I need to get on that Lotto record first and foremost.
Yeah.
So he heard the record and he was like, that's the single.
Been practicing social work and therapy for about 25 years. So when I was a little girl, I kind of had this knack for listening to people, and I was pretty good at it. And so people would always come and talk to me about their problems, even like the adults. And for some reason, I was just like the person to listen. Inadvertently get into counseling and therapy, and just it was just very natural for me, and it didn't ever feel like work.
By the time I got to the Beyonce audition in 2007 and I didn't make it, I was like, okay, this is what I need to do in order to make it. So I really wasn't defeated. It was more of a what's my plan of attack to go get this job that I know is mine. And so 2009, I did that. Well, 2008, I quit everything. I quit the Sixers, quit Atlantic City, quit teaching. I got packed my little car up and I drove down to Atlanta. And I started taking classes and just really worked on who Kimmy would be on stage.